Hi guys, expatriate in the Philippines. If you like the following video, please give me the thumbs up. If you did not like the video, you can give me the thumbs down. But do please make a comment to what you disliked about the video. I can then probably improve my channel and content for other people. If you have subscribed, thank you very much. If you have not subscribed yet, please feel free to do so. Press the notification bell so you get notified each time I upload a new video. And feel free to share with all your family and friends. So, enjoy the video. Bye. Good morning, guys. It's expat Ian in the Philippines. Watching the sun go up again. So, today is Sunday. Now, Sunday in different countries, they all have their sort of own traditions. I've been to quite a few countries around the world, and it's amazing the different ways they all have. For example, I mean, it's different now in the UK, but when I was a child in the UK, Sunday was I'm not religious at all, so, but I do know that Sunday is the day of rest. So nobody goes to work. Sunday is a family day, and we have in the UK our traditional Sunday roast. Why we had, or why is it called the Sunday roast? When I was a child, we never had any big meals during the week because we didn't have enough money. So it was just small meals and snacks. And then on the Sunday, that was the only day then we had chicken or roast beef or a nice piece of lamb. At least we had then one proper meal in the week. I can remember, I think it's changed now. I left the UK in 1981, and I know a lot has changed. I can remember every Sunday, this smell in the house of my mum's cooking. First, you have the roast that's in the oven. Oh, my mum used to love baking, so every Sunday there was also a cake or desserts. There's a dessert called trifle, which my mum used to love doing, and. And so while my mum was at home cooking, my dad, he used to be then out down at the pub for a few pints before they go home. And then in them days, I don't know what it's like in them days. So the father, so he used to be working all week. Yeah, Sunday's the day off. So he used to go down to the pub Sunday morning, have a couple of pints, and go home. And usually the meal is on the table waiting for when the boss gets back. Then we used to have our meal, and then
I remember Sunday afternoons was then football was on TV. And then after the football, then the film. So that was the Sundays. Like I just mentioned, I left then the UK in 1981 and went to Germany. Germany was very strict. So on a Sunday, also I'm not sure how it is now, no mowing the lawn, no washing cars, no construction, which means no banging and drilling, and not allowed to hang your washing out, and all these types of things. And again, Sunday was like then a family day, and also no shops are open. Everything was closed. So that was a mad rush then on a Saturday in the shops, because also that time, 1981, the shops closed on a Saturday. I think it was 6 o'clock in the evening. So you can imagine a mad rush Saturday afternoon. Because the other thing was the guys or the women used to work and till Saturday lunchtime. Go home, change into your normal clothes, and then go off shopping before the shops closed. And then I can remember they changed the rules. I think it was from 6 o'clock then to 8 o'clock. And then the big stores, they changed it to 10 o'clock. And there was so much trouble. It was, oh yeah, the poor women are working these stores and they also have a home. And anyway, so back to Sunday. So Sunday, they changed then the laws that the bakeries could open in the mornings. I'm not sure the times, but long enough so the people could get up, go to the bakery, and buy their bread rolls for the breakfast, and some eggs and whatever. And it's also like a tradition in Germany, the 3 o'clock coffee and cakes. So the bakeries and coffee shops, they were allowed to open up again in the afternoon. So the Germans used to go out for their walk down into the town and sit at these coffee shops or bakeries. They do nice cakes, by the way, in Germany. And I also noticed in Germany, also the men, they also, Sunday morning, so similar to the UK, they all go out to a bar, or they have like parks where there's a place where you can sit and buy your beers. In Germany, they call it Frühschoppen. Like early drinking on a Sunday morning. And again, the woman would be at home cooking. And then when the guy gets home, the meal is to be on the table when he gets back. I remember my ex-wife, her parents. So he used to go home and sometimes the meal wasn't ready. He got a little bit upset. Yeah, and while I was in Germany, I think UK, they started changing the laws that some of the shops could also open on a Sunday. So, for example, I'm not quite sure now exact time, like 10 o'clock in the morning till 4 in the afternoon or something. And also, there was a big shopping thing called Tesco's. Now I do know that they also started 24-hour shopping. So they started that, and then the Germans started to, some of the companies wanted to do the same thing, and there was an uproar in Germany. No, the knights are for sleeping, and Sunday. Oh no, Sunday is a day of rest, church, family day. And then what they were not thinking is, all the poor women, they have to work then all week. Well, if you think about it, they don't. You'll have like rotation shifts, and which we started to do in the company I was working for. So I also had to work Sundays, and it's like you work. It was five days on, two off, but then rotation. So some days you had to work Saturday and Sunday, and another time, and you'd have, Tuesday, Wednesday off. And then it would just keep on moving and rotating, because we had not three shifts in a day. It was then four shifts. So, anyway, back to our Sundays. Yeah, the Germans weren't happy about it, but in the end they started getting there and realised, no, it's not a bad idea. So I think they've started doing that also. I think, I'm not sure. But it was weird. So England, so you went out to Germany, and Sunday's like, it's just dead. You're all quiet. And because of that, when I did leave Germany in 2007, I headed off to China, and oh wow, there is no weekend. The Saturday and Sunday is just like a normal day. Also, the companies. So the company I was working with, the actual production lines, they work Saturdays and Sunday, 24 hours, 24/7. Good morning. Basketball?
Yes, sir.
Yes, of course. And that was weird. Trying to get used to also the streets. You went into Shanghai the week, Sunday. It is packed full. All the shops open. Many, many of them 24 hours. And you're thinking, God, back in Germany, they're all moaning about, and China, it's just, it's normal. And I see it also here in the Philippines. Sunday is, it's like a normal day. Coming back to China, there was when we were working in Germany, it came to Thursday or Friday, so the bosses would go around already asking for volunteers to work at the weekend. So they'd come to you. You'd say, any chance of you working at the weekend? Said, no way. Weekend is for stopping at home, being with the family, going out doing things, party. And in China, it's the other way around. The workers come to you. Can we work at the weekend? Oh, that's sorry for the noise in the background. The dogs waking up now. So, yeah, they used to come to you. And if you said no, they were really upset. So it's just this way of thinking. Also public holidays, because they get extra pay. So in Germany, we would be, great, it's a public holiday, we'll stay off again, be with the family, and again, all the shops would be closed because it's a public holiday. And so in China, totally different. you wouldn't, well, you know it's a public holiday because you get all these buses with tourists coming in from all the provinces coming into Shanghai. And it's the same in the Philippines, really. Sunday is not much difference to the rest of the week. That's why sometimes, now I've stopped working, I do get sometimes confused which day it is. You always have to look on the calendar. Funny, when I left China, the guys I was working with, they asked me what I would like as a going away present. And I like these Chinese, these digital clocks that they have. So it tells you the day and the time. And like they have this, it's like waterfall or whatever. I said, I'd love one of those clocks. So I can hang that on the wall. So it would remind me of China. And so I'll know which day it is and what the time is. So, okay. So when I had the, when we all got together before I left, they gave me a present and they gave me a watch. Very nice of them. It's a very nice watch, but it's not exactly what I wish for. But it's nice. It's nice. Yeah, so I do have a problem sometimes knowing which day it is. Let me know how the Sunday is where you live, and if you have any like special traditions, like do the men go out in the morning, meet up with the guys with a couple of drinks, and the girlfriend or wife stops at home, does the cooking, and what do you do then Sunday afternoon? Okay, it's the one of our neighbours. I think I'm going to have to. It's okay. All right, thank you. Good. So they love their big pickups, the trucks, similar to the Americans. I think that's where they got it from. Yeah. So let me know how your Sunday is. So it's not in the Philippines. I know in the Philippines it will be virtually the same as mine. But, I don't know, Australia, New Zealand, in America. What do you guys do on a Sunday? So, the sun is now it's not well and truly up. Here again. So give us another day. Yeah, I'll leave it at that. And I'll catch you guys. I'm not going to say like or dislike or whatever. We'll just leave it at, I hope you liked the video. Found it a little bit interesting to see how Sundays are in different countries. So I'll catch you guys another time. Have a good day. And from me, it's goodbye.